After protesters chased Supreme Court Justice Brett Kavanaugh out of a restaurant this week, the intimidation isn't stopping there. A leftist group is offering people cash money, a bounty for intel on where the justices are, up to $200, and leave it to Kamala Harris to serve another word salad about codifying Roe versus Wade.
Did Democrats fail past Democratic presidents, congressional leaders, to not codify Roe v. Wade over the past 5 decades?
I think that, to be very honest with you, I do believe that we should have rightly believed, but we certainly believe that certain issues are just settled. Certain issues are just settled.
Clearly we're not.
No, that's right. And that's why I do believe that we are living, sadly, in real unsettled times.
Alicia, what's really unsettling about this to me is that...
Did she mean to say unsettled?
Yeah. It's best I got. It's best I got, guys. It's Saturday evening. Let's roll with it. What's really truly unsettling about this to me is they're offering $50 just if you're, and they went after the food service industry folks, you know, the people that $50 can make a big deal in their lives. Hey, just let us know that they're here. We'll give you another $200 if they're still here when we get there. Like, this is okay, but somebody we were talking to earlier today on Fox and Friends made the point. If you're just talking to politicos out there, that's one thing. They're going to show up and protest and do their thing. But there are crazy people in this world, and they show up every day and do something evil. You know, and that's who you're talking to as well.
Right, exactly. And you never know where that message is going to land, who it's going to land on, and what they're willing to do for the person who has said, I'll pay you money, I'll retweet you, I'll whatever, give you attention. It's a frightening prospect, and it's a frightening prospect for people on both sides. That's what they seem to be missing here, is that this can affect everyone.
Yep. Well, and I guess what's so concerning is the Justice Department has opportunity. They have legislation on their side. They have policy on their side to kind of shut this down, at least at the homes of justices, and to really tamp it down and show that the leader of the Democratic Party, the leader of the Progressive Party, does not condone this. But we're going to take a look here and see what the White House actually has to say about it.
If these protesters can go to a justice's house and they can go to a restaurant, where is it that you don't think it's appropriate for a group of protesters
when
to go?
We condemn intimidation. We condemn any violence. Peaceful protest, people should be allowed to be able to do that.
In a restaurant?
If it's peaceful, for sure.
Really?
Peter,
isn't that creating a potential really bad situation when there are people, even if they're being peaceful at the time, they're angry?
Peter, we have condemned any intimidation and violence.
Restaurant.
I'm done here, Peter.
Doctor, she's speaking out both sides of her mouth, is she not?
You know, I'm right with Peter when he said, really?
Really?
I mean, it's exactly how I feel. She says, we condemn intimidation and violence. What does she think it is when people are waiting for these justices outside of their house, outside of restaurants, and now paying money to be told where they are? Let's not forget that Justice Kavanaugh, there was just a threat against his life. Mm-hmm. Why is this not intimidation? Listen, peaceful protests in history have made some progress. Women's suffrage movements, MLK, but that's not where we're at these days. You have these social justice, not even warriors, but hooligans who are going out, intimidating people. They're causing damage and destruction. Why don't they actually take this energy and put it towards good? What the Supreme Court justice did just now was they actually gave a voice to the people. They said, take it to the states when it comes with the decision with abortion rights. So now these people, instead of going and intimidating the justices and threatening and disrupting the peace, disrupting businesses, why don't they actually take it to their state legislation? Why aren't they calling their state legislators every single day, trying to get legislation on the books, putting forth the people that they want in the elections, and take it in the true democratic fashion that our country is built on?
Sometimes the loudest... Go ahead, Jimmy.
No, I would agree with that 100%. I'm in a dicey position with this story, because Fox does pay people to chase me out of restaurants when I'm on vacation. They don't want me to look too fat in my wardrobe. They're like, he's had enough, send him in. I think the reason you're starting to see them mobilize is the left is in a politically difficult position, because this did not move move the needle the way they thought it would. They thought the overturning of Roe versus Wade was going to be like this seismic shift on the ballot. But if you look at the breakdown of what people are prioritizing, this still isn't like a top five issue number one.
That's right. Saying the quiet part out loud. Yeah. Why are they so upset? Because there's an election in November, and they know this issue is not top line.
It's not what they want, because here's the deal. The abortion rules aren't going to change where people are in favor of them not changing. Yeah. Meaning sending it back to the states means New York and California are going to have all the abortion they want. If you're in a red state, you may have to cross, you know, state lines to get an abortion, or you're going to look at a 15-week cutoff. The silver lining I'm looking for is, hey, if people do have to drive to blue states to get abortions, maybe this will make Democrats prioritize gas prices. Maybe we all win here. I don't know.
Can I just say something real quick about the way the messaging was handled there with the White House press secretary? Because in watching that exchange with Peter Ducey, which to me, it really stuck out. When someone is trying really hard not to say something, they use a lot of words.
Yeah.
If you're going to condemn an action, then you're going to condemn an action, and it's quick, and it's very easy to do. Yeah. That did not happen here.
Nope. You know, on that topic, let's take a listen to the White House sage on this, VP Kamala Harris, and some of the clarity she's brought to subjects over the time.
We got to take this stuff seriously as you are, because you have been forced to have to take it seriously.
We will work together and continue to work together to address these issues, to tackle these challenges, and to work together as we continue to work operating from the new norms, rules, and agreements that we will convene to work together on to galvanize global action.
For Jamaica, one of the issues that has been presented as an issue that is economic in the way of its impact has been the pandemic. We will assist Jamaica in COVID recovery by assisting in terms of the recovery efforts in Jamaica that have been essential.
Can someone get her a teleprompter, please?
Yeah, really.
Alicia's a point. Communication. Get in front of the messaging. I mean, she's all over it, right?
To her credit, she does communicate like a 19-year-old who came home stoned and ran into their parents. Now, I know you guys can't relate to that on any level, but it's the obviousness of the things she says. You know what I mean? Well, we're working together to work together, because working together is important. This is what you do to your parents. You're like, oh, you guys live here? It's like the most obvious thing in the world. Yes, of course we do. We lived here for 20 years, but that's that nervous, weird tick, and she just looks so inauthentic, and that's the part that is killing
me. I think the veil's over all of our eyes. I believe she's put out there to do that specifically to make Joe look better with his own communication problems. That's what I think. Okay.
We'll know when she starts riding bicycles.
All right.
Hey, Sean Hannity here. Hey, click here to subscribe to Fox News YouTube page and catch our hottest interviews and most compelling analysis. You will not get it anywhere else.